Omega Alpha, your source for effective supplements through science since 1992, including Regeneric, Iotic 8, Hemex, Equine Liver Flush, Healthy Horse, Testos Boost, Minarec, Equine Anti-Flam, and many more.
Your colors just right out of the trunk.
I actually sometimes I'll text Mike Wilder in the morning and I'll see if it's gonna rain. He says yes, because it usually rains at the Meadows most of the time. So I got some rain colors in here. This is my extravagant driving bag. I actually have a couple more, but I like this a lot better. It fits me. It's a dollar. So
oh hi, let me take that for you.
You have any room in your trunk?
Oh yeah, let me pop the trunk. Nice. We don't have to stop for coffee.
On the way, when we get there.
Okay, we will wait before we get there. Yeah.
Did you guys know I'm not a morning person?
Now, which way are you going to go? Route 8?
You tell me. I mean, this is your route.
Make a left at the. I usually go left. I usually go left on my driveway.
We're going to take. So left and then go down that way?
Yeah. You know how to go that way?
I think so. It takes you down like the old Ford plant.
Yeah, you go past there and then you even go through that extra.
You're straight getting driven today. This is bull.
I know. Thank God I'm out of the backseat. You'd be seeing a car sick mofo.
You can't. Oh, you can't sit
in the back? Oh, man, no. I'm not great at riding.
So when did you retire Road Dog?
Okay, Road Dog's been retired for a little while. He has drove me, and this is 2018?
Yeah.
Maybe once or twice.
Okay.
Mondays usually, especially, I usually stay if they have like an open. I'll stay there for like till the open most of the time and then go to Northfield on Mondays. Mondays card is Northfield's very, very good.
Like, it's so weird to think like what you guys are doing. Obviously this new generation is, you know, the catch drivers really what's come along, what, late 90s into the 2000s, maybe even the earlier 90s. But back then, like your dad, like my dad, like everybody drove their own horses.
Yeah.
It's so different. To get 1,000 wins, remember that was like the greatest thing in the world. And now it's, you know, obviously who's gonna get 1,000 wins a year. Right.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, and not even blank, you know. But like, just to do what Hervé, like, you know, I mean, if you think about it, Hervé, you know, in the time that he did it, and you know, I think they said he bought a Hertz, like, you know what I mean? He would like sleep in the back. That's crazy to me, you know. Like, he'd have a driver and sleep in the back in between tracks. But yeah, I mean, he was way before his time. I remember when I don't even know if I was 10 or 11, maybe. Mm-hmm. And he came to Northfield, and they had those, that was like the first year they had little harness racing cards. I had him sign a card for me. I could say, like everybody said, it's normal. I was just kind of like a normal kid, you know? And then it was a race, like when my dad be racing, I would like to watch him race, but anytime the barn worker there, I never even thought about it. I was behind the doors playing basketball or something like that, you know, if I was at the track.
You know, it's hard to believe that you just finished your second 1,000 win season, because I remember was it 6 years ago? You were going to do it, and then you got hurt.
Yeah.
But you were on pace to do
it. Yeah, I was on a roll, you know what I mean? And it's hard to get on a roll and stay in a roll in this, you know? And like I said, everybody's like, ups and downs, and that's the truth, you know? And I just kind of take mine in smaller doses, like hopefully, you know, you have a bad day, then you got tomorrow, you know what I mean? Or you have a better race, you got the next race. And you know, and I think that, and I hate to say it, but that accident, I think really, really changed my outlook and my life in a way, you know, on this. And I'd be one to go in the driver's room and, you know, turn right here and, like flip the programs off, or you know, throw my helmet against the wall or something like that, you know what I mean? And not mad at anybody, just mad that I lost when I thought I should have won, you know. But it's really, really changed for sure.
Now explain to us, when you talk about that accident, what did you break? Was it elbows, or was it what
I broke? I had open compound in my right wrist and my left elbow, so it was pretty disgusting. My like right wrist,
right?
Yeah,
okay.
Right, and then my right wrist was hanging from like less than an inch of skin.
Mm-hmm.
My elbow was you know, compressed and it shattered, and my elbow was through my skin there, and I broke my left wrist as well, and I broke my neck. So it was
what was the recovery time? I can't remember.
I made it low over 4 months. They said it could be a year to year and a half. And then my my doctor says to me, man, he's like, you're one motivated SOB. And I said, no, I'm one bored MF-er.
Yeah.
But we'll keep it PG. I'm not much of a cusser anyway, but.
I just remember you got into commentary. You like tried my job out.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You were good. That's what everyone said. They're like, Aaron is really good when you were on there with me and Cody.
Yep. Dan Gisser a long time ago, too. It was cool. Yep. That was a different accident. I had a couple commentary stints, you know, via my accidents. But yeah, I liked it. You know, I was just talking. Yeah, MSOA. Yeah, they do a nice job, and they actually spend some money to, you know what I mean, like to really to, you know, promote the sport and just do nice things, you know, especially for the horsemen there and stuff like that. But
when does the day start?
Like usually try to get the, like my driver change done by like 8:45, 9:15 somewhere in there. Like if I have like the Meadows is always in the morning, Northfield's a lot of times at night, and then I'm like. Yeah, and most of the time in a zone, I'll get my colors ready and shower and sometimes let my dog out and then really don't want to leave. I'm just being honest with you. I just sit there. Sometimes I'll fall back asleep on the couch watching Sports Center and it rolls into first take, you know, at 10 o'clock. But I'm not real gung-ho about getting in that car in the morning. I will promise you that. That's it. I wish like there's like a conveyor belt of the racetracks, like a giant one that just goes around my house. Like when I race at the Meadows comes to me. Or if I race at Lexington, the Lexington comes to me. That's why I morally just like own a bicycle and or skateboard or something like that.
What makes you be like, I'm going to do it?
I'm a sicko. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
is it people, for the money or is it for the wins?
No, it's for to win races and like to be, you know, like I said, accountable for, you know, you're listed. You got to be there, you know. Of course,
people do depend on you.
Yeah, they do. I mean, people do this for a living, you know, and they write your name down, or now it's used to, you know, it's online, and they put your name down, expects, well, I know I got Aaron, and Aaron's going to be there. Aaron's not going to call off, you know what I mean, and stuff like that. And sometimes I think that's somehow times where I got my drives, you know, there's some guys that call off or whatever. Like, I don't. Like, you know what I mean? Like, there's something seriously wrong if I call off. There's something happened on the road. Yeah, and then, or when you get people get all excited, you know what I mean? Then you don't do good. They're like, man, I was all pumped up to have it and you suck today or something like that.
Do you think people are like that?
Yes.
Yeah, they're like, what is your favorite horse to drive for the
kid? It used to be Tamarind. And actually, he's racing this weekend at Northfield. He sold him to Nick Rowland.
Okay.
In Minnesota there. And to Stan Stud, and they're gonna, you know, of course, race him a little bit and Stan Stud. But I liked him a lot. You know, he's not the greatest horse in the world or anything like that, but man, he was tough. You can like move him early, especially even at the Meadows.
No, he could take so much.
Well, for a horse that chokes and stuff like that. And he's little and he's just like a little bit of round and Barn Girl. She reminds me a lot of Tamarind. Little. I mean, just very, very, very gritty.
Is she off right now?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. He gave her a break. She's had a long year, you know, last year. And you know what? It's a long year, even though, like, she didn't have a lot of starts, but she, shipping a lot to race, you know, because she went a couple in a row at the Meadows, and then they wouldn't let her race there. And, you know, and she raced a couple Grand Circuit races, and she won. And, but, you know, just, and she does it tough, you know, and neither one of the horses, those two, like, really grab on, but they, you know, you can just race them, and they, like, the rougher, the better, it seemed like, so. See, now, when this card's over, I'll be waking up, like, my eyes will actually look like they're awake.
So we'll get you awake on the way
home. Oh, I'm awake now, actually. I'm, like, awake, like, mentally, but just, like, physically, I don't think I'm all the way up yet. If they raced it, like, from, like, 12:05 post a.m. to, like, 5, I'd probably be close to undefeated. Everybody else, they would be sleep. Everybody would be sleeping.
You're saying
that's
like
why the night cards. The night cards at the Meadows. That's my gravy. Meadows is very, very good. You got like an hour between the hour and the half hour. You know what I mean? Like so.
Yeah.
They want you there an hour, but you got a half hour leeway. So I'm usually always pushing it. You know what I mean? 20.
We'll have to get coffee, and then they want to. Mark's setting up a camera with you all day. So.
On my face. Good day or bad day, you got adrenaline going. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, especially because this is something I love, you know? So, and I'm competitive as all get out, you know? So, like, you get to the Northfield, then I'm like, okay, let's go. You know what I mean? You always want to try to start off with like a nice winner, a nice winner, you know. But Ronnie said my winning percentage went down this year, like of
Ronnie Wren?
Yeah, he says my winning percentage went down this year of like my first drive, because I used to just like come in there for for sure winner. Like that's what I would try to do. But I've not done it as well this year, I guess.
What is your win percentage right now?
It's like 24% all the way around. So that's pretty good. That's what who called me the other day, Gordon Waterstone. So I'm pretty actually proud of that. That's you know, that's all the tracks combined.
You're almost a quarter of your starts are wins. How can you not be proud of that?
Yeah. I mean, that's, yeah.
That you always say the horses and the trainers, you know, and the owners, you're always the first to thank them.
Oh, just, they work hard. I mean, like sometimes it seems like I don't do anything compared to what they do. If you think about it, you know, they're up every day in the morning, and you know, I mean, sometimes they have very, very long days, and there's a lot of them are shipping and whatnot. And I feel actually ashamed. I don't know what I'm gonna pass down to Christopher. I mean, I can like do some things, but like nothing like my dad, you know.
What do you think your relationship with Lanny, which has always been strong, like,
yeah,
has taught you to your relationship with Christopher and then with your daughter as well?
It's helped a lot, you know. I mean, just like, you know, my mom's in my life as well, but
right.
You know, but I just, my dad's there, you know, I just see him all the time, but you know, they're two kind of different people, but two of the same, you know. And just having someone to be able to, like my mom, even like in saying, hey, text or call, or you know what I mean, to always be like, okay, you know what I mean, someone to either talk to or, you know, criticism, or say, hey man, I'm having a bad day. Like my dad, you know, you're not allowed to even have a bad day. He's like, there's no such thing as a bad day, you know. And that's the way he honestly feels, you know, which I think it does help. And he kind of tries to snap back into you, and I was like, so what, you'll win 5 tonight, you know what I mean, if you have a bad day at the Meadows. And he legit will call me like if I have a bad day or good day, it doesn't matter. He says, okay, forget about it, it's over with, you know. And anybody will tell you, it's hard to forget about sometimes. And oh, experience and time, yeah, that's what I mean. I agree, like, you know, and as much as I'm on the road, like I said, I try to go home every day. You're like, there's no, you know, even when I was racing the stakes, I mean, I would drive the 5 hours from Lexington, whatever. I just try to go home, like, whether it's 5 minutes or, you know, 5 hours of that day, like, I want to see my kid. Like, I mean, that's the truth, you know. It's tough, but on the days off that I have, like, I mean, I really, really try to push to, you know, see my kids. You know, I wouldn't see my daughter for a couple of days. I actually took a day off. And it's really, really tough, you know. I mean, thank goodness their mothers are, you know, great to the kids, you know. So it makes it a lot easier for me. But, I mean, I genuinely, that's what I do miss. Like, I miss
being there.
Oh,
yeah.
Man, when you have a kid, well, I'll tell you what.
My thing.
Your whole outlook changes.